Hey there, everybody. In this video, we're going to talk about Instagram. I'm going to tell you why you should be spending a ton of time inside of Instagram, especially if you have a business that's business to consumer. It is one of the best platforms for digital marketing right now. And if you're not actively using Instagram, you need to be. This is very, very important because your clients and your customers are spending time there. We're gonna go into this, where you should be posting, what kind of content you should be putting out, and how to really use Instagram to get the most out of it. So if you're using Facebook already, that's awesome, but this is going to be specifically about Instagram. So let's get into today's video. Hey there, everybody. My name is Brandon Brashears. I create daily digital marketing videos. So if you're looking to grow your brand or your business with digital marketing, be sure to subscribe to this channel. Give the video a thumbs up if you like it. And if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out. I'm happy to answer questions and respond to the comments and things. All right, so let's get into today's video, Instagram. Instagram has tremendous user growth. If you are in North America and the United States, over a third of Americans are on Instagram. That's amazing. That is like, there's never been a platform with that kind of reach and active users. What's really interesting too is that demographics from young to getting now older are also using Instagram. So it seems like it is kind of the just general to-go place right now that most every age demographic is using. Some interesting stats about Instagram. There are 600 million daily stories on Instagram. That is amazing. That is a huge platform. It's a huge amount of users. And I think that the stories feature of Instagram, if you're not familiar with it, it is 15 second videos or still pictures that people post that go away after 24 hours. So that kind of temporary feel to that content makes people come back to see what's going on in their friends and their family's lives. Now, some interesting stats for business. You say, well, that's great for a user standpoint, but what about for business? 72% of Instagram users say that they have discovered and bought a product using Instagram. That's tremendous. That's a huge value. So if you have a business and you want to be in front of your customers and your clients, Instagram is a great place to get them to discover your product or your service. The other thing that's interesting is that 80% of Instagram users follow a business. So people are not opposed to following and engaging with brands and businesses. Now, Instagram is very heavy on visuals, and I think that there's a few things that you need to understand. First, the placement of the different types of posts and content. So you can do photos and videos in the Instagram feed using up to 60-second videos. For ads, you can use up to 2-minute videos. Typically, the best resolution is square images and square videos just because they're supported inside of that mobile feed and they look best there. You can use 16:9, like standard 1080 videos as well that are like this kind of orientation. For stories, those are in portrait. They're not in landscape. So a lot of times if you're going to be creating these, it's easiest to just simply create them on your phones. So inside of stories, you can have only portrait is the format that's supported. People could twist their phone sideways, but it looks far better if it's in portrait simply because that's the way that people engage. Inside of stories, you have the ability to tag with hashtags, tag people. If you have more than 10,000 followers, you can swipe up. If you're putting one of your IGTV videos into that feed, you also get the swipe up, which is kind of cool too. So I'll give you a few more tips and tricks with that in just a second here. But I just want to go over the major placements with this. So you have stories, which are great. And if you think about stories, it's kind of like people just flipping through TV stations until they find something that's interesting. If you've ever experienced that, right? If you're just flipping through channels, that's really what the feel of stories is. You have to capture people's attention and hold it because the next story is one swipe away. So stories are a great and engaging way to actually engage with and converse with your clients and your customers. There's some really cool things that you can do with those, like questions and people voting on things and getting actual engagement, seeing how people engage and then messaging them back directly once they do engage with you. So it's pretty cool. And then there's IGTV, which is a product that they've been pushing a lot. And IGTV is longer form videos. If you have less than 10,000 followers, it's up to 10 minutes. You upload those videos on desktop. They have to be in portrait orientation. They cannot be landscape. So you have to also export your videos in portrait to make it work. The thing that I think is huge about Instagram is that it seems like it has the sticking power, and obviously, you know, as platforms get older, typically they become less cool and people move off of them and younger people move to different platforms and have their own thing. But Instagram seems to have that really cool factor. And I don't think that most people truly understand the value of their brands that they have established on Instagram. And what I mean by that is like the celebrities and the people that have huge followings and they actually get amazing engagement. You know, I think of people like Kim Kardashian, Cardi B, Taylor Swift, The Rock, these huge celebrities. They have this outlet where they can communicate directly with their fans, with the clients, with the customers, and that kind of access has never been seen before, right? So you have tools to reach customers and clients. Now, Instagram is really, really polished. It's beautiful images, and typically people that are, you know, super beautiful and fitness people, and it's kind of like the highlight reel and not really real life, right? So that being said, that's what you're competing with. If you think about Facebook, that's like a big political family fight, right? So if you go on Facebook, it's just like a dumpster fire of politics and fighting and, you know, all that kind of stuff. And maybe your newsfeed is different, but a lot of the people that I see are constantly bickering about politics. Facebook is a great place for longer form content. You're able to use the headlines and body copy and good stuff like that. But the thing about Facebook is that they're running out of ad space, and that's because the users' growth is not still happening. More advertisers are jumping on board. It's getting more and more competitive. So what is Facebook going to do? They're going to branch out, add additional products, add more ad products, and really help to promote growth inside of their other products, which is WhatsApp and Instagram, and, you know, using these different outlets that have tremendous user bases. So that being said, it's important that you're able to diversify your traffic, especially if you're definitely, you know, most businesses that I talk to these days, they've run Facebook ads. They don't necessarily realize that you can also use the same ad platform that Facebook has for Instagram. So it's the same ad platform, all of the amazing demographic targeting options, but the format is a lot different from Facebook. So you need to figure out ways to engage people natively inside of Instagram. And the ways to do that are, there's actually 8 types of ads. And if you click on this video up here, I go over those 8 types of Instagram ads in depth on each version so that you can use each one of those to get more out of your marketing. If you're doing Facebook ads though, and you just push them over to Instagram, you're probably gonna have poor results because Instagram is a lot different from Facebook. So if you are just getting started, number one, start using Instagram a lot. See what's working. If things are trending, if things are you see that are popular, figure out what is the common link between these different things and how can I use them. If you see brands and businesses, especially inside of stories, more companies are going to stories, although I think they're very, very undervalued for what you get and the attention that you can get for stories ads. But when you see something that really sticks out and looks good to you, figure out what is cool about that. I like to go and actually record the screen. And especially if it's very, very creative or interesting, I'll actually go and record that screen so that I can look at it later and reference it again for some inspiration. So I see especially related to camera products and film products and stuff like that. So like lenses and Canon does a great job. And several other brands are doing really cool ads, specifically inside of stories. Another brand that I think is really, really cool is Super 73. That is a great brand. They make electric mini bikes that are super cool, and their ads are just super engaging. And I'm sure that they're getting great conversion out of them because they're creative and they're using all different kinds of angles in their marketing. So check that out as well. But you have to become a user of the platform if you want to be successful at it. You need to understand what works, what doesn't, why people are spending time there, how they engage with ads, how they engage with posts, you know, tagging their friends, commenting, how do you get comments, engagements, tags, and that kind of thing. I think Instagram is such a visual platform that it works really, really well with ads and content that's more of a show me type content. So it's not so much reading and thinking about like Facebook is, it's more of a show me. So if you take a look at ads that work really, really well, it's like product demos. If you think back to like, you know, Slap Chop, that one guy from like the Billy Mays type thing, right? Which is the old infomercial style, but like, let me see what's happening, let me see the transformation, let me see what the benefit of the product is. And if you can see with your own eyes, it's going to be powerful, it's going to move people to take action. So how can you show people what the product does? How can you show them what the before and after is and get them to take action? Make them feel emotion, make them feel like they can get the result based on the demo that you're giving them. I think that that's tremendous opportunity, especially for physical products. It's a little bit different with services, but you need to figure out, how can I show these clients and customers exactly what we do, what the goal is, what the before and after looks like, so that you can convey value quickly. I think that that's really important too. You have to convey value quickly. It can't just be, you know, more long form. Until IGTV comes out, it's going to have to be shorter form. So capture people's attention, figure out what the next step should be, and make it easy for them to take action. So get started with Instagram. I'd love to see, comment down below with your Instagram handle. Be sure to follow me on Instagram. I'm at Brandon Brashears. If you like this video, be sure to subscribe, hit that thumbs up button, and I'll see you on the next one. Have a great day, everyone.